Hello children, now we'll begin with chapter 3, that is input and output devices. Let us begin with the chapter. As we all know that computer works on the IPO cycle. Computer follows the IPO cycle, that is I for input, P for process and O for output. So if you can see my colors also, I have taken input as red, process as yellow, and when we mix these two colors, the output is orange color. Okay, let us begin with the chapter. Children, as we all know that our body is made up of different parts. Each part has a specific work to do. Yes, a human body, every part has a name and has a specific work to do. Same way, a computer is made up of different parts. Each part works together to do their specific task. These parts are called devices. Yes, a computer system has different parts. This is a monitor, this is a mouse, this is a keyboard, and this is a CPU. So all these parts have their specific work to do, and the parts are called devices. We say input devices, output devices. Okay, we don't say parts of computer. Okay. Now, this is an extra information for you. This you should know. This is the basic information when we come to a computer class. We must know that computer works with two different parts. One is a software and one more is a hardware. You can see the different parts. They are the hardware. Whatever parts that you see, that is the input devices, processing devices, output devices, storage devices, this is hardware. Hardware means we can touch it, we can see it, we can touch it, okay. But software is the like a heart, we also breathe, na? Same way. This is the part that makes the computer work, but we don't see it. Like for example, Windows 10 or the MS Word, the Paint, these are all the software a computer used to do a different work with that. Okay, every software has a different work to do. Computer classification, first of all, computer works on software and hardware. And software are of many types. I have given you only two. Hardware, it can be the input device, whatever you can touch and you can see. Now, what are the input? Input is entered inside the computer with the help of a few devices, that are keyboard, mouse, microphone, scanner, touchscreen. I have given you a few examples. Processing is done by the central processing unit, that is the CPU. And output is displayed to you on a monitor with the help of a printer, plotter or speaker. There are a few more, but these are the basic things. Okay. Now, input devices. The devices that are used to enter data and give commands to a computer are the input devices. To give data and commands to a computer, to tell the computer what to do. Now, first one is the keyboard. Keyboard is an input device. We press keys to enter data into a computer. Data can be numbers, letters, symbols, etc. Anything that you type, that is, you are giving the input. Mouse. Mouse is a pointing device. Input can be entered by clicking, pointing, dragging, and dropping. These are the very important things that you should know. One more example of an input device is the barcode reader. Children, when you go to the malls, nowadays everywhere, restaurant, everywhere you can see the barcode reader is used. Barcode reader is an input device. It scans barcodes that are printed on every object. This is a barcode. Now you can see in even in a small pencil, eraser, everywhere you will see there is a barcode which tells the computer what is that item and what is the price of it. Every detail is entered in these lines. Microphone. Microphone is an input device. It helps us to record sounds and also our voice in a computer. What are the use of a microphone? It can record our sound and also the voice, and also can send it anywhere. We can also talk through this with our family and friends on internet. Children, when you have online classes, you are using your microphone to speak and the teacher can understand what you are saying. Scanner. Scanner is an input device. It scans any pictures or documents and displays it to the monitor. Yes, on the scanner we keep any paper, any photo, anything you want to scan. You can just keep it over here and it will be displayed on the monitor. Processing device. CPU, the central processing unit. Central processing unit is the processing device. CPU is the brain of a computer. It works on the input that we give and presents the result as output. The work that we want to do on a computer, first we give input, then the CPU. Children, this is the CPU box. It is not the CPU, but it is the CPU box. What is a CPU? A part, a small part inside the CPU box is the CPU. This is the brain of a computer. Output devices. The devices that displays the result of the input given are called output devices, where you can see the result. Let's see. Monitor looks like a television. Monitor is a input output device. We can see videos, everything over here. Monitor, it is an output device. It displays the soft copy of the work done by us on a computer. Soft copy, a new word for you. Children, whatever output we see on the monitor is a soft copy. Why? Because we cannot hold it in our hands. Only thing we can do is we can see. Again and again we can play and we can see, but we cannot take it in our hand. Next output device is the printer. Printer is an output device. We can take hard copies of our work on printer, on paper with a printer. Yes, we can take. Now whatever work we have done, we took it on the paper and then we can do anything. We can file it, we can use as a project, anything we can do. So we can touch this. These are the hard copies. Plotter. Plotter is an output device. Banners, big size charts, advertisements are printed with plotters. Children, you can see this like banners everywhere. When you go to the market, you can see different advertisements are put na in a big size paper. These are printed with the plotter. Printer can print only a few size, that is a very small size of pictures, not the posters. Okay. Speakers are also output device. It is used to hear the audio, music or any kind of sound in a computer. If your computer has any kind of sound, you can hear it only with the help of a speaker.
When troubles come and my heart burdened be, then I am still.
Okay, we'll go to the next one, that is the headphone. The headphones, the earphones that you are using. Headphones help us to listen music, audio or any sound without disturbing others. Headphones without microphones are output devices. You can see there are two headphones. One is without a mic and one is with a mic. So this is input, output plus input device. We can also send our voice through this. But this headphone is only an output device because it doesn't have a mic. Now comes the storage device. Devices that are used to store data and information are called storage device. Yes, you can store it for further use. Most important one is the hard disk. Hard disk is a storage device. It is inside a CPU box. Okay, it is present inside the CPU box. Hard disk stores all our work even if suddenly the current goes off. So you know where your work is stored. One more hard disk is there, which is external, which is not inside the CPU, but it can be used separately. CD and DVD. CD means compact disc and DVD is digital versatile disc. These both are storage devices. A DVD can store up to 7 times more data than CD. A CD can store very less amount of data, that is maybe one movie or a few songs or a few cartoons, but a DVD can store more than 3-4 movies. Pen drive is also a storage device. It is also called a flash drive. It can store even more data than a CD or a DVD. Can be carried anywhere. You can see, and you have already seen a pen drive. Yes, children? So you know what is the another name for this. It is flash drive, and it can be easily kept and carried anywhere. Let us recall what we have learned today. Yes, the classification, that is computer works with the help of a software and hardware. Software can be Windows 10, MS Word. There are many, but I have given you only 2 examples. Hardware are the input devices, processing devices, output devices and storage devices. Input devices of computer. Touchscreen is an input device because when we press anything on the mobile, that means we are giving you the input. The computer gets the input when we touch the screen. On a tab, on a mobile, okay. Camera, yes, we can click the photo and send it to the computer. So camera also is an input device. Scanner, joystick, this is used to play games. It is also a pointing device. Keyboard, mouse, webcam. Yes, children, nowadays we are having online class. Some of you are using computers. You know what is webcam. It sends our images and videos to the other person. Trackball. and microphone. These are the output devices. This is the projector, which is used to send from our computer or laptop to a big white screen. It sends the pictures over there. Plotter, printer, speaker, monitor. Now the storage devices, pen drive, floppy drive were used before. Nowadays it is not used because it has very less storage capacity. The cassette tape, not you, but your elders have seen what is a cassette tape. We used to listen to the audio with this. Then the internal hard disk. I told you there is an internal hard disk that is inside the computer. There is also an external hard disk. It can store a huge amount of data, huge, okay. It goes to a very high limit. Then CD and DVD, and also the memory card that is inside your mobile phones. Thank you for listening, children. I hope you have understood the chapter. Take care and keep learning. God bless you all.